Adam and Jamie are attempting to resolve the controversy that a steam machine gun was an effective weapon of war. It's already been proved lethal at close range.
Isn't that awesome?
But how will it fare with a more realistic target? Cue the human analogue.
The steam machine gun's about to claim its next victim. The ballistics gel is nice, but I want to see what happens in real flesh. And that's what this is. Don't worry, as soon as we're done with this, Jamie's gonna take it home and cook it and eat it this weekend. I'm not kidding, he's gonna eat the whole thing.
Not by myself.
But before the barbecue, they want to tenderize the meat. Porky and the foam regiment are in Adam's sights.
All right, shoot the pig in 3, 2, 1.
The gun again performed. But did our porcine test target survive?
I think we hit it.
I think so. Question is, did they go in?
It doesn't look like they did. It looks like one glanced off of him and went through here. We got a hit right there.
That probably broke some bones, though.
Yeah, but that's not a lethal hit. That's
no penetration.
So Porky was pummeled. But without so much as a flesh wound, the claim that the steam machine gun was a lethal weapon of war is looking busted.
I just don't think it can kill. It never pierced our pig, and I think that's really where the rubber meets the road with a weapon of war. You don't want to just dent the enemy. You want to kill them.
Unless you're standing right at the end of the barrel, it's not a deadly weapon. But Adam and Jamie want to try all the angles before consigning their steam machine to the busted bin. They're going to test the full extent of the gun's range.
We're now going for real distance. So we've angled our cannon at the steepest angle we're comfortable with, about 20 degrees, which tells me it ought to fire around 500 yards. And we're going to actually test this out and see.
It's full steam ahead for the range test. Adam amps up the ammo. The gun's locked and loaded.
Everybody, we're going hot!
Adam, keeping his Hollywood action hero dream alive, gets into character.
This one's for distance and for glory!
With the gun at full speed, Adam releases the balls. But the rig isn't happy, and chaos reigns. Jamie kills the steam on his side and frantically signals for Adam to do the same. But with their machine gun spiraling out of control at 2,000 RPM, Adam's taking no chances. He reaches around the ballistic shield and finally shuts it down.
Oh, I think that might be the last thing our cannon does.
It came to a grinding, shuddering, fatal stop. But as this high speed shows, it wasn't in vain.
My God, what a beautiful shot.
So at least one bullet left the barrel before the shutdown. But where'd it go?
Apparently Jamie found one way out there. You got one.
700 yards.
No. Dude, that's just under half a mile. That is really nice work, man.
Unexpectedly, the gun fired a full 275 meters further than the Civil War specs, which leaves the myth scorecard looking like this. But if you add a crucial fourth category, it's not nearly as impressive.
Soldier.
Sir, yes, sir.
What do you think of the steam machine gun as a machine?
Sir, it functions effectively as both a machine and a gun, sir.
Soldier.
Sir, yes, sir.
What do you think of the steam machine gun as a weapon of war?
Sir, it's not very effective, sir.
Okay, let's get out of here.
It was mostly dangerous to Adam and Jamie. Myth busted.